Hey, everybody. Happy Fired Up Live, episode 9. Can you believe it? The show has been growing like crazy thanks to Fire Disc Nation. And I'm sure thanks to that Fire Disc Cookers group, because you guys are unbelievable on there. And Hoyser Country, of course. So thank you for growing the show with me and just having fun, tuning in. We've got great things lined up tonight, so stick around. We've got special performances. We have lots of coffee drinking by yours truly. We've got prize winners and chances to win a giveaway and just so much more. So thank you for everything. You guys are making my night and I hope you're having fun already. Make sure that you're commenting below today. Just whatever you want to tell me. Give me ideas for the next couple shows. I'm looking for some new recipes for my Fire Disc cooker because I've had a little time. I want to get a little more creative. So what are some of the amazing things you've made on your Fire Disc? I want to know. And of course, we've got Valentine's Day coming up. So you know it's a great gift. Yes, not only Hoyser Country Blend coffee, but a Fire Disc cooker. We've got discount codes. You can go over to firediscookers.com and grab a Fire Disc or any swag with a nice little deal off there if you use the code Claudia Hoyser. And if you go to hoysercountry.com, back it up with a little Hoyser Country Blend for Valentine's Day gift. And we got you covered. So look, you're shopping here at Fire Disc Nation. You didn't even know it. Thank you guys for tuning in. I am going to stop rambling and do a little song for you to get this show started. What do you want to hear? Let me know in the comments. Except I'm doing this, so I can't really read them right now, but I will. I will be sifting through in a little bit, so make sure you're commenting away. You've got chances to win your own Fire Disc cooker tonight, Fire Disc swag pack, prize pack, Hoyser Country Blend coffee. All the good stuff. I'm going to tune up for a second here. What do we want to hear tonight? Hopefully some country music, because that's what I've got lined up for you. All right. That should do it for now. You know, I'm feeling really good about tonight's show, and just want to spread a little positivity with this one. How about that? I'm going to do Humble and Kind for you.
You know there's a light that glows by the front door, and don't forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church 'cause your mama says to, and visit grandpa every chance that you get. It won't be wasted time, always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, and don't lie. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When those dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. And know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone you love. I love you ain't no pickup line. So always stay humble and kind. So hold the door, say please, say thank you. And don't steal, don't cheat, and don't lie. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. Shut off the AC and roll the windows down. Let that summer sunshine always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. You get where you're going, don't forget, turn back around. And help the next one in line. Always stay humble and
thank you so much. A little Tim McGraw for you. That one was written by Lori McKenna, who is also an amazing songwriter. If you guys want to check that out, she's got her own music out there on Spotify and Apple Music, and she's written hits for so many people. It's crazy when you start to look into all that stuff. But of course, we love Mr. McGraw's version of that one. We've had some friends stop over to the brand new FireDisc flagship store, and we've heard all great things. So if you've been over to the store, I want to hear about it. Let me know if you've been. We've got our coffee over there too, so you can grab some if you're in Texas. It's outside of Houston in Katy, Texas. But we've had one of our friends who works for Alan Jackson stopped over, and he sent us all these pictures, and he's loving it. And it's really cool because when he's not out there driving and working for him, he's definitely heading up this way to upstate New York and picking up our coffee up here. And he's a great friend, so it's really cool to see that some of our followers out there and some of our really good friends and family have been making their way to Katy, Texas, visiting the FireDisc store, and it all just kind of comes full circle. It's crazy the things that music ties you to. Never thought I'd be doing a show about grilling food and singing country music, but it really goes hand in hand pretty well. I'm going to put this down because I think it's almost time to bring on our special guest for tonight. What do you think? I think so. What do you think? Think she's ready to join us? I think so. Let's do this, you guys. Make sure my hair is all right. Ready. Fired Up Live has yet another amazing woman of country with us tonight, and I admire this artist in so many ways. I'd like to introduce you to someone who didn't take the easy road to stardom, but instead, she chose to make her own mark her own way. And that she did. She took the industry and her fans by storm with her wildly successful multi-platinum international debut, Did I Shave My Legs for This? And of course, we all know the song Strawberry Wine. Let me introduce you to my friend, Dina Carter. Hi, Dina.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm doing so good. Thank you for having me.
Of course. Thank you so much for joining us on Fired Up Live tonight. Everybody's been so excited and sending in questions for you and all that good stuff. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for having me. Really, it's been so much fun doing these things and getting to meet new people this way, you know?
It's nonstop, isn't it? I feel like I'm working this way more so. It's like traveling on tour through the computer. So you get what you get sometimes, and it's least we're able to do it a little bit.
Absolutely.
So you're in Florida right now?
I am. We are
lucky you.
About a mile from the Gulf, actually, between the bay and the Gulf. So I've had a really long walk today, and Just so beautiful. The sun's out and it was warm. And, you know, we've had rainy winter weather too, very cold. So it's been a nice break.
That's so nice. Well, I dream of places like that. We're in upstate New York, so it's been gray all the time. January has been exactly like you would expect.
That's why Nashville was always hard. Nashville was like from November to March. It was just so depressing and dreary, but spring and fall were to die for. So
yeah, we definitely have to make our own sunshine in the studio. So
yeah,
when we need a little bit, we'll just write a happy tune and just kind of put ourselves there. So what has been going on? Have you been traveling at all?
I have not. Honestly, we were talking about this morning. My last show that I did was an acoustic show in January of 2020. So that was it. And then the last band show was the end of fall, like right probably the first week of November for 2019. And
oh my gosh,
just like everybody, we didn't have a clue when we hugged goodbye for the holidays in 19 that we would not see each other again until 2021. Good Lord. So
oh my gosh, I know.
It's been challenging for sure. I've never been home this long in my entire adult life.
I was going to say, this has to be so new and so strange, and you're trying to find ways to stay busy probably. And I know that you are. Yeah. You've got so much going on with your socials and everything like that. And I'm sure other things at home. I've been following along a little bit. So what kind of things have you been up to at home, just trying to find a new way?
Well, when we moved out of LA, my son decided to come with us here to Florida, and his dad had gone to Louisville. It was a very different time because we'd always been really close, like a couple of miles down the street. Mm-hmm. We could see each other. So it was a huge transition for our extended family because we've always been a real team in that area.
Right.
So the adjustment this summer, and it was him coming and making the decision to go to the public high school here. And he's just the main thing when you watch your children bloom and be so happy. I mean, aside from a few teen things here and there, he's 16.
this is Hayes.
Yes, this is Hayes.
I saw him in your recent Instagram video. I think you guys were on a golf cart, and you could just tell he's like, "Oh, mom, put the camera down."
I know. Oh my God, I'm the cringiest to him. I mean, he thinks, you know, like cringy. Every teenager. Yes, he thinks I'm cringy, but he's just been so happy, and that has made the biggest difference because I've just worried about him and you dote over him and everything. And when they're showing that they're really happy, and he was saying, you know, "Mom, I'm living my best life. I'm so happy here." And that has been amazing. So that's
amazing.
Been a huge amount of energy going into making sure that he is adjusted and happy. And, and we've, you know, obviously we're thrilled. And the adjustment of moving, and just, it's been a crazy year. So we've been doing housework. We're, that's why I'm in the dungeon room, because we're
we
working
tell.
On the
house. It looks great.
We are working on the house everywhere. And we're going to knock it out before March because I hit the road. Hopefully we got some shows coming back in the spring. Obviously taking all the precautions, but we are going to get back at it, you know, and get back out there. So doing social posting, house, diet, health, Hayes, husband, all that.
Unbelievable. Well, the real question is, does your son like country music?
He has, you know, coming from LA,
he has a wide range of tastes.
Yes. He was, R&B and hip rap and stuff. And now we were driving for his driver's test, and he's like, "Mom, turn it on the country station." I almost had a heart attack because he hated country music.
Who's this next to me in this car driving me?
Yes, but his friends now down here listen to country, and so he's kind of gotten into that.
Wow, that's so awesome. Well, I've been following along a little bit with your Wing It Wednesdays and TGIF. Mm-hmm. Tell everybody a little bit about those, because you need to follow Dina on her social adventures, because it's so much fun. And I feel like you just bring such a positive little message at the end of the week for everybody. And it's just nice sometimes to open your phone and see some down to earth, you know, message that, I don't know, you're pretty, like, it's just you hanging out and being yourself. And it's really nice when that comes across so authentic for people that follow you.
Thank you. You know, Wing It Wednesdays are really fun. We decided during this uncertain time to do hump day, middle of the week, to have a music, just kind of what's going on, keeping people encouraged in the middle of the week and throwing in some music, taking requests, getting people to come on live with us. And that is a live broadcast that we do. And Jake, my tech guy, is awesome. Obviously, y'all wish I had Jake today because we had a hard time for me getting us together.
We got all the tech worked out finally. Yeah. You guys have no idea what went into this today.
That was me.
We missed you,
trying
Jake.
Trying to handle it. Yes, we missed you. But so Jake takes care of all the wrangling all of us together so that we can hang out and have a live, just a little fun. Jim and I sit on the couch and play music and covers and some originals and we were talking about new stuff early on, and we quit doing that because it just didn't fit with keeping people upbeat. So
it's hard. It's really hard.
Yeah.
I tend to stick to just the music too, and I keep my things kind of personal, and I let everybody kind of think what they want, and they all can wonder what the heck I'm thinking, but
exactly.
Just sip my coffee and play my songs for now.
I know. And then Friday, my TGI episodes, I've been doing those for 4 years, and they have been very helpful for me to stay
4 years. Wow.
Grounded. Yeah. I did my 207th last week. I'll be on 208.
Holy cow.
And every single week, like on the road and everything.
That's so impressive. I do Hoyser Country Mondays, and we're not up that high yet. We've got a couple years under our belts. I think 118, but
yeah.
I'm so bad at counting them. I feel like you've got it down. You're like, I know, 208. Okay, ready to roll.
Well, it helps if you do them by year, obviously, and then you know. But I keep the episode numbers going chronologically. But that's just where we dive into the Bible and see what God says about what's happening in our current world, because. Mm-hmm. We've had church taken away from us, and I don't know. There's nothing new under the sun. So it's really kind of fun to go see what he has to say about all the shenanigans that we're going through.
Right.
And I don't feel like the focus has been on that enough in our churches and society. So I'll go dig up scripture, and girl, I've gotten so many interesting responses. A lot of people are very supportive for the most part, but mm-hmm. every now and then I'll get, like, you know, a lot of times people don't want to hear the truth.
So it's hard. You just have to be true to yourself, and there's always going to be people that agree, and there's always going to be people that disagree. And I think that just staying true to you is going to keep our heads on straight, keep us sane.
Yeah.
But there has been so many changes, and I think that it's nice sometimes that people can open up their phones and find maybe somebody or a bunch of somebodies that they can relate to in that way. So that's amazing that you're doing that for your followers, and I think it's great.
And it's also a little confession. It honestly started out when I was wrestling with things in my heart or whatever. Mm-hmm. I was being very open, like, God, this week I was so mad, and blah, 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 you know, and I would like dig and read up about what I needed to work on. Mm-hmm. And then I just found that people had common threads. So it just has evolved into this, like, what does God say about our society? Let's dig in and read it. And everybody's like, shut up, I don't want to hear it.
That's when I usually sit down with my co-writer and I'm just sitting there venting for like an hour. And then he's like, okay, I guess we should write a song about this then. I'm like, I don't know. Exactly. I don't know. I don't know if I can write about it yet, but usually turns into something decent. And I know that you kind of carry that method into your songwriting as well. Like, it's all very personal to you, right?
Absolutely. I love to sit with someone and spend that hour at least just talking, like, well, where are you from? Are, you know, are your parents married? Or did you go through, you know, what is your story? It's sort of like your little testimony. And that's where the songs are, always in the cracks of all of that. That's mm-hmm. where they sit. You know, mm-hmm. I've never been good at saying, I mean, people that carry titles around, I do envy them. I cannot do that, because that method doesn't work for me. But I'll just say what's going on. And always in our conversation is the tagline, the title, the, you know, and I start writing down when people are telling me, like, the therapy session. Mm-hmm. And that's where this, for me personally, that's the most effective approach for writing.
It is such a therapy session in a way. And I always, you know, I get choked up often when we're writing, and I am like,
yeah.
It becomes very difficult to write about a certain topic when you feel that way. But you know that once you push through that, that's when, like, the best song comes out of it. So it's kind of like an up and down battle sometimes going through it. But then at the end, it just feels so good. And you know that if you've been through something like that, that feels that much, there's a good chance somebody else has too.
Yes. The hardest writing I ever did was after my dad passed away. And
wow. Yeah.
He was always such an inspiration. You know, I'd never sung a note without him. And he was my sounding board, my guide, his method. He was a very well-known guitar player and played on all these famous records. And he was on the A-Team in Nashville. And so
amazing.
When he passed away, I would sit and look at a guitar like, I hate you, you know, or whatever those feelings, like, how can I ever, not him. I mean, I felt that way towards the instrument for a while because I literally, that's what it represented. It's really hard to put my feelings into words, but I got together with my friend, Tyler Hilton, and we wrote Waiting for You to Come Home. And I mean, I cried like no other. It was so cathartic just to let all of that out, the disappointment and anger and sadness and loss and all of that. And so your co-writers really are brave to sit in those rooms with you and vice versa.
Sure,
no matter if it's romance or whatever, you know, when you're willing, and sometimes you just can't help it, you just like regurgitate all your stuff all over them. And so it's a very intimate relationship, the co-writing situation.
It is. It is. Do you have like a certain group that you typically write with, or are you just kind of all over the board for whatever creativity you can muster up? You work with a bunch of different people all the time.
It's funny because I love to, and I haven't done this in a while. The approach for me is twofold. One is to go back to people that would write with me when nobody knew who I was.
Oh, I love that. It's so
that
important.
Is always the person, like Chuck Jones, I wrote half my first record with him.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
People, it means so much to me because we're always that little girl or young guy inside wanting acceptance and support, and you don't ever forget the ones that were there for you.
Right.
So that is like huge on my love list, but also working with brand new artists that, and I'm very selective. I'll get, you know, sent their info or their tape, I mean, their videos and stuff. And I'm pretty picky, but when they're good ones and you see all that just like fire in them and the talent and everything, that is really inspiring too. So it's been nice to kind of be in the middle of the bookends of that.
That's so, so good to hear. I think that the loyalty side of things, people really take for granted sometimes. And it's just so important. That's something my co-writer and my manager has always stressed to me from day one. Like, it's not just about making the relationships. It's about maintaining the good ones. And so it's something I keep really close to my heart too all the time. So it's great to hear from you too.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm in the studio all the time and I'm not always getting a chance to speak with other artists, and we do these Fired Up Lives and I'm like, oh, she feels that way too. It's really cool. So that's great to hear.
Now, do you have, I have a bucket list though still of people like that I never got to write with on the way up. And Paul Overstreet and I were texting this week cause he was asking me some questions, and I said, when are we going to write? Dude, it's like 25 years.
I've been waiting forever.
I said, you're still on my bucket list. Yo. Hello.
What did he say?
So,
is it going to happen?
I hope so. He's looking for a spot to come down and vacay with his wife. And so I said, well, here's
bribe
some
him
references.
To Florida. Be like, there's a beach, you know, we can do lunch and maybe knock out 3 hit songs.
And write our song. Finally, it's going to be huge. Yeah.
That's so awesome. Mm-hmm. You're coming up on a huge anniversary.
Yes.
25 years.
Yes, I'm 25. I mean, thank you for wishing me a happy birthday. I just turned 25. No,
okay. You're getting younger by the day. And
no, did I shave my legs for this? That album, my first record, is 25 years this year.
What an amazing title, by the way.
Thank
I love
you.
It. And it's going to work. It doesn't matter what year it is. That will always be such a perfectly coined phrase where you know exactly what you're talking about. And it's just so awesome. I love it.
Thank you. I'm so excited. We've got a few things in the few irons in the fire for what to do. You know, on the 20th anniversary, we Universal, what's Capitol, but Universal, they came to me and asked about an album, a vinyl release, which I was so excited. And they did that.
Oh,
and
that
was
so cool.
Fun. And I can't believe it's been 5 years. So we're talking again about some cool ideas and we'll see. But this year I'm blown away at the loyalty of the fans, just the support system that has been. All of our shows still sell out. It's unbelievable what a song and when you fight for what you believe in. And as an artist, not to shake my finger at you, but as an artist, and it was hard to do in the 90s, I was like this determined that I was going to co-produce my record, which I didn't get credit for it at the time.
Oh my gosh.
But I'd co-produced that whole record, the one with Bowen and the one when we brought Chris Farron in to help finish some new songs. And I was part of the packaging, part of the imaging, part of the video, you know, just hands-on, fiercely driven and focused. And no one was like cookie-cuttering me out of Nashville like they used to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so grateful to Scott Hendricks and the label for getting behind that. And we had some bumpy times, but that's what it takes. Like, you have to stand your ground. They stand their ground. You come together. And that's what makes music timeless. And I do feel like that's missing today, is taking that development time, taking that artistic vision, all the thing, you know, everything's so immediate now. So that's why it has lasted 25 years, is my whole point, is that I was super driven and focused and the label was very supportive eventually and it ended up happening.
It's amazing. And it's beautifully put. And it's so true. Like, you put your heart and soul into that and it's still shining through to this day, like louder than ever. And everybody knows Dina Carter. So it's just
thank
amazing.
You.
And
thanks
in a great
so
way, you know, in a great light. So
thank you.
Everything we're doing is pretty DIY too. And in the beginning, I thought that that's not the way it works. You know, you think, how is this going to go? You don't. I was able to, my manager kind of opened all the books to me and just said, if we're going to do this, I think that you don't necessarily want to be a product. You're an artist. And, you know, hearing that and hearing somebody take me seriously was just like, it just, at that moment, I felt like I figured out who I was. And from that point on, it's taken us a really long time to put out a record. And in the beginning, I was probably like super impatient. And now it's like, it's such an easy feeling knowing that, yes, it's taking a long time, but it's only because I'm getting a chance to work it out the way we want to. And it's going to be my mark and our mark and just doing it the right way. So never thought it was going to happen this way, but it's kind of rolling down the same DIY, carve your own path type of thing, and we've had this amazing following start to get on board. And so I just thank everybody for following along tonight with Fired Up Live and everything we're doing.
Yeah.
And if you don't follow Dina already, you better go do that, because she's my kind of gal. So
it's so cool. Like, I wish we had these kind of platforms when we had come out before. You know, we went out in
how you did it. I think about it every day. I'm like, oh gosh, we got to go on social media again. And then I'm like, what if I didn't have this? What? I don't know how you did it.
Well, the beautiful thing about it was we were hands on in the car regionally with our radio reps, you know, our regionals, mm-hmm. going to all the stations, right. meeting people. It was about the relationships. And, but this is, look, I can't imagine how it would have gone over with this kind of platform, you know, because it was, it reached so many people. Television was a huge part of that.
Mm-hmm.
My management at the time was fantastic at getting me on every national morning show, every national, like Letterman, Leno, all the talk shows at night. And that was very difficult. No one, especially a new artist from Nashville, a girl, was not going to get on those things. And so that's, this here is just an extension to reach that many people. And that was the key to breaking through too. It was the marketing thing. So
mm-hmm.
it was great. I mean, I just pinch myself still, because it was a lot of work.
Yes.
Oh Lord, it was
and
so
it
much
still
fun.
Is, I'm sure. You're still working your butt off. I mean, you've got so much going on still and so much more to come, especially in 2021.
But it's so, God, I look at it like I would do that again in a minute. I don't regret a second of it.
That's so, so wonderful to hear. You have no idea. Because every day, you know, we're digging in and you just think for a split second a day, like, am I crazy? And then you're like, maybe, but I love this, so I wouldn't do anything else.
Yeah, it's so true. It's a gift. When you have gifts, if you don't use them, that's been a challenge. I'll say that about this time away.
Mm-hmm.
I'm guilty. Like, I've not utilized all of my music. That's why my musical ability, you know, mm-hmm. I'm not sitting with a guitar every day writing like I should be, or it's an adjustment, mm-hmm. because I'm used to being on gone to do it.
Yeah.
But that's why we started Wing It Wednesday and the Friday thing. I added music in and trying to do sweet little posts to just bring a music moment and sing to people, because I don't want my gifts taken away because they're not being used.
Right.
Because I'm not using them like I should be. Mm-hmm. You know, so I'm ready to get back to work and sing every day. Sound checks. I can't wait.
Know.
Like,
it's such a feeling that you just can't get anywhere else. It doesn't matter if you have the brightest, shiniest lights in your living room. It's never going to feel like that. But at least there's a few ways to kind of make it work while we can. And do you think that you're going to be, do you know when you're going to be getting back out there?
We are looking at March, like the late March and then May. We just have like a few little one-offs,
mm-hmm.
to test the water and see, you know, if
yeah.
things, now that's the plan as of now. We'll see if it comes through. But, I even miss being self-conscious and nervous on stage. Like the stuff I used to hate, I'm going,
you're like, where are my jitters?
Yeah, I know. I want to feel that trust. That's mm-hmm. what I miss, is the trust that you have with the audience, you know, the people there that are to support you. It's just like they came to see some good music and you can't let them down, number one. But also, you know, I don't know, there's something about like, gosh, am I doing it right enough and okay and good enough? Like, the challenge of all that is really important.
Do you think it's going to be different when you go back out? Like, now that you've had,
yeah.
probably the longest break you've ever had.
Ever, yeah. Oh, for sure. You know, I go to bed really early now, and gigs are usually late.
Right.
That, my sleepy tea will have to wait until way later. But it's going to be great. 2021 is going to be awesome. And
I agree with you. I agree. I keep setting little high hopes. Like, you know, even if things don't actually follow through, I'm going to pretend that they're coming up, because then you have something to look forward to. And if it doesn't work, you just got to figure something else out. But it's going to be great. and I have high hopes for you starting out in March and May. So congratulations and good luck.
You always have to make people wonder, what is she celebrating? Like, what is she so happy about? You know, because that is important. And frankly, 2020, as unique as it was, mm-hmm. it was so full of blessings for me. It was challenging, which is a gift because you learn new things. It was, you know, the home time and all the things that I'd longed for decades because I was never home for long. Yeah. We got it all in a year. And even through loss, you learn things. You know, it's just I just can't help but be a glass half full person. So 2020 was a huge blessing. It was hard. Mm-hmm. But it was, I'm not looking at it like it was all horrible. I think that there were some good things that came out of it for us, and challenges too, and loss for people that lost loved ones. That was horrible. But you grow through those things too.
Yeah, and they inspire a lot of new music.
Yeah.
I feel
and
like
I want to your coffee. I'm like, the amount of coffee I have had this year is like surpasses decades.
Well, what kind of coffee are you drinking? What do I have to one up here with mine?
Well, I hear I'm about to try some yummy stuff.
Hoyser Country Blend.
I know, I can't wait. Honestly, I love, I just drew a blank on the name. Oh my Lord. The chicory coffee, the Cajun coffee.
The Cajun coffee?
Yes, it's what my grandmother always had. I know.
Oh my gosh, I've heard about this, but I've never tried it.
It's like from Cafe du Monde, and you know, it's Louisiana coffee.
Yeah, community coffee.
Yes, community coffee.
Oh my goodness. My coffee co-founder is obsessed with community coffee too. And that was like part of our biggest trial thing when we were trying to figure out our perfect blend. It had to like totally top community coffee in our world. Yeah. So
community coffee.
But not with chicory. Ours doesn't have that.
Yes.
So we're going to have to get you on this stuff. You're going to have to try it.
Yeah, I'm excited. I will.
It can make up for all the sleepy tea at night and just get you going in the morning.
Awesome.
Well, we would love to hear some music from you. If you feel like singing a song, I think that we would love to hear something from Miss Dina Carter.
You got it. I would love to sing for you. Thank you.
What are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing two songs.
Okay.
I'm going to sing if I can.
Yes,
I'm going to sing. I will, of course, do Strawberry Wine because it is 25 years. It's still going. And I'm so thank everyone for that. And I think I'm going to do You and Tequila because there's still a few people out there that may not know that I co-wrote that song.
You sure did. And I love, I love it, love it. Okay, that would be so wonderful. So grab your guitar. We'll just kick it over to you.
Okay. This song will always be special.
Strawberry wine and say he had to go. A few cards and letters and one long distance call. We drifted away like the waves in the fall. But year after year I come back to this place just to remember the taste of strawberry wine at 17. The hot July moon saw everything. My first taste of life, so strawberry wine. The fields have grown over now, years since they've seen the plow. There's nothing time hasn't touched. Is it really him or the loss of strawberry wine at 17. The hot July moon saw everything. My first taste of life, so bittersweet and green on the vine. Ooh, like strawberry wine, strawberry wine.
So I wanted to do you in tequila because a lot of people aren't aware that I co-wrote this song that Kenny Chesney made a huge hit with Grace Potter. And I wrote this song with Matresa for an album that I did around 2003 or 4 called I'm Just a Girl was the name of the album. If you go on iTunes and look for it, you can find my version of You and Tequila, which was the original version, which I love it. I wanted to produce that song sort of like a Tracy Chapman vibe. So it was really cool when I was on tour with Kenny and Keith, and they would hear the song and come listen every night when we'd sing You and Tequila. And the fact that he ended up recording it like 10 years later was amazing because we got to go back to the Grammys and the CMAs and the ACMs and the AMAs and all these amazing honors that we got to revisit. Matresa and I got to do that together again. It was really special. So this is You and Tequila.
Here I am again, kicking dust in a canyon wind, waiting for that sun to go down. I made it up Mulholland Drive, hellbent, don't get high. High above the lights of town, you and tequila made me crazy. You run like poison in my blood. One more night might kill me, baby. One is one too many. One more is never enough.
never made me crazy. You run like poison in my blood. One more night might kill me, baby. One is one too many. One more is never enough. When it comes to you, all the damage I could do, it's always your favorite sins that do you in.
Goodness, how do I get so lucky to just keep getting these little private concerts? Everybody is loving this. Thank you so, so much.
Thank you. That was beautiful. For listening. Thank you.
Of course. I know it's not a giant room with awesome lighting and huge surround sound yet, but we'll get there. And for now, that was definitely warming my heart, keeping this inspiration going. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
I have a few questions from our followers that have sent them in wanting to hear a little something personal from you. Do you mind if I rapid fire a few questions off from some of our friends out there in Fire Disc Nation?
Put them in my hand. Come on.
Okay. Well, I hope I get the last names right. I'm going to try my best. Okay. Everybody's going to be excited about this. So this one, you've got to think a little bit back here. We're going back into the time capsule. I'm not exactly sure how long ago this was, but Alton Anderson wants to know if you remember the night you sang at the Swine Ball at the Tennessee State Capitol, and there was an electric storm that night, and you were very excited to go watch it from your penthouse suite at the Lowe's Vanderbilt Hotel. Do you remember that?
I do. Yes, I do remember that. That was that night. And I'll tell you, that was one of the first nights that I want to say, and I may remember this wrong, but I sang like by myself. I didn't have band with me or anything. Mm-hmm. And I was really nervous and I had to walk in, you know, I had been living in LA for a long time. I hadn't been in Nashville. I'm a huge, like, Nashville, Tennessee. I'm a Tennessee fan. Mm-hmm. And so I hold in high esteem the people that run our city and our state, you know, when they do the right thing and do a good job. And I remember it just being such an honor to be there. And I was like, oh my gosh, I hope I can pull this off without having like my band and everything. I was pretty nervous about that. And yes, I did. I always stayed at the Lowe's in Nashville. It was my hang. They had a good wine. They have good wine there.
They have good wine. I'll keep that in mind if we ever get there. Yay. But that has been one thing that definitely came up with the whole quarantining and sheltering in place, is like having to step away and really work on the guitar and feel comfortable in doing that by myself. And that was definitely a nervous jitters moment. And Yeah. So I know how you feel, but it does feel good sometimes to be like, okay, I did that. Now I can go drink wine in my penthouse suite.
Yeah.
Okay. Duff wants to know, Dina, who are your influences or who has influenced you in your career? And did you think that Strawberry Wine was a hit as soon as you heard it?
Well, as soon as I heard Strawberry Wine, I knew it was my story. And I'm like, I lived it to the nines. Every line felt like what I had personally experienced. And I fought really hard for that song to be on the record. I took in, actually, Strawberry Wine and We Danced Anyway in the same meeting.
Oh my
and
goodness.
Matresa Berg had demoed them up. Her demos were always like records. They were very good. Mm-hmm. And I was not wanting to record outside songs at all. So, you know, they're pitching me all these songs. We had already done a whole record and we were re-recording to do a release under a new label head and everything. So I was not real open to outside material, honestly. And I said, well, if I'm going to sing outside stuff, then it's going to be stuff I've lived and I want to connect to. And so I brought those in. And a lot of people claim that they brought them in, but I brought them in.
Everyone listening right now, Dina brought that song in. It was all her idea.
Yep. That's right. And danced together. So they were like, these two go together. And so I fought for that to be on the record. And I also fought to leave the bridge in because they wanted to take the bridge out of the song. They thought it was too Beatles.
Good idea, keeping it in there. And I think that everybody feels the same way you did. Like when they hear that song and you singing it, it's like, this is my story, even though, you know, we're putting ourselves into your shoes. But it definitely comes across that way. So, and I wasn't planning on asking you this, but since you just brought this up for my own little personal reasons, I need to know, what was that like re-recording? I can't imagine after everything we have gone through to get these, you know, tailored the way we want to dream them up. I can't imagine going back in and re-recording the music. And since I've never done that, I just want to know, was that easy for you to do?
It was difficult. Like what the difficult part was the changes at the label, like the uncertainty of who's going to be doing what, and they drop artists and they keep artists. And, you know, it was a busy time back then. Labels were packed full of artists. They had great budgets and this and that. And so it was very frustrating to have had a record with full lush strings and all this stuff. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it was challenging. And that's why I wanted to keep as much of the first record feel as we could, like with a lot of the bass tracks that we had done. Mm-hmm. So we really literally did half and half. We kept half of the original record and brought in new things that I had either written or like Strawberry Wine and We Dance that I related to and blended them together. So it was a happy medium. It was a nice blend of everything. And that process became really fun when you could hear the lineage between the two phases. Mm-hmm. That's when it was like, oh my gosh. And that is why I wouldn't let go, you know, of like having a say, because it had to be congruent with the vision all the way across the board. So, but yeah, it was scary. Some scary moments there of, you know, I'm going to pull my hair out or what are they thinking? Or, you know, there was a lot, but you have to just like stay focused and lean into the positive things that are working and focus on all that. And the rest will work itself out.
Beautiful. Thank you so much. Yeah. I was just, I truly was curious because I think I would just die. But I know that sometimes when you revisit a song, it only gets that much better. And obviously it worked out so well for your release. So amazing.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
More rapid fire questions. Adrian Avila wants to know, do you have a favorite song to sing?
I love to sing Strawberry Wine. Mm-hmm. Every song on that first record, because of the process we just talked about, is so special to me. Before We Ever Heard Goodbye is one that I love, because of the finger picking, which is took me forever, but it's like, so to sing it,
beautiful. Is,
you have to go, I want to remember that love and feeling. When we were young and our hopes were high. It's very hard to sing and finger pick that song because your voice is going do 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 do.
The melodies are totally different, yeah, but they weave together so beautifully.
Thank you, but I love to play it because it's like this pat your head and rub your stomach thing going on through that whole song.
And you're like, are you seeing this, what I'm doing right now? Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's amazing. Yeah. Mike Small would like to know, do you remember, okay, this is also reaching back, so no hard feelings if you don't, but if you do, Mike Small wants to know, do you remember meeting a Pennsylvania high school football coach at the University of Tennessee in the student bookstore? And I have no year to go along with that. So,
oh my goodness. Pennsylvania.
And what book did you buy? No, I'm just,
Purpose Driven Life. No, I don't know. No.
That worked out.
My goodness. It's so hard to remember every single person that you meet. It sounds familiar, but I don't want to be chumpy and say that and then disappoint someone. So I can't remember that exactly. It feels familiar to me, though.
Well, Mike, we owe you, and we say hello now, and we can't wait to see you at our shows someday soon. So keep in touch.
Please come back. Yes.
Neil Dennis brought this up, but so did so many other people. So we have to know, I'm sure you get this all the time, are you related to the June Carter Cash family? And then David Parr chimed in, and what about Jimmy Carter? Any relation?
Oh my gosh. Well, the June Carter is still out there. And I just did a post. We're not sure is my answer because.
Oh. We're going to have to do some ancestry.com type of thing going on.
Yes. And before she passed away, I worked with her at an award show and she pinned me against the wall and she goes, you confuse the hell out of me. Oh, and I said, right back at you, sister, because she looks just like my aunt, just like the cheeks, the whole similarity. It's very odd to share the name and have so many similarities. So we are seeking that out. We're looking into it. I just posted recently, Jake's working on the post for my socials for the Carters. I went all the way back to the Revolutionary War and saw some graves of them, and so we are in the process of figuring out where that connection is. And my dad worked with Maybelle and was very friendly and was in the studio with them, so there was always sort of this love connection either way, like Carlene as well. She was always super sweet to me, and
amazing.
It is crazy how much we favor each other, I think.
Absolutely. Well, you have to keep us posted on that because we've got to know. Okay, two more.
And wait, Jimmy Carter, my Pawpaw Carter used to freak out about people thinking he was kin to Jimmy Carter. He's like, we farm cotton, we don't farm peanuts. You know,
oh my
God.
That's awesome. Okay, Mitch Ladorf wants to know, are you going to make a new country album? Or are you planning on going pop, rap this year?
No, oh, Lord. Kidding. Yeah, I should do a rap record. Oh, yeah.
I think that would be good for you. Really stretch the palate.
I would love to work. You know, I always wanted to work with Whitney Houston, and I never got to do that. But there are some R&B artists that I just think are amazing that I'd love to work with. And that's where my rhythm is. You know, I'm like a 2-4 girl. I don't feel the 1-3. I feel the 2-4.
There you go.
And I'm funky Cole Medina. So it would be amazing.
Beautiful.
To have that kind of an influence in something. But I will say my record was the first album in country music to have a drum loop, like a rap loop on it for How Do I Get
so
There.
That's so cool. That is so cool. Do you have another record coming out for 2021? Is that something everyone can look forward to?
definitely working on it.
Beautiful.
So we're going to focus on the shave anniversary, and maybe on the tail end of 2021, we can sneak out a new one.
Awesome. Okay. Last but not least, how do you drink your coffee?
I like it black.
Black. Okay. There you go. That question came from Ashley Wiseman, by the way. And yes. We had to know. I think that's like a fun fact to start to learn about people, how exactly they drink their coffee. And do you drink now, it during the day or just in the morning, at night, after
that's
dinner?
That's what I was going to say. Mm-hmm. In the morning, it's black with nothing in it. In the afternoon, it's iced with a little protein, caramel protein juice in it, you know, milk,
wow,
creamer.
Fancy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that on the keto diet that you follow?
It is.
Oh, this is a new bullet point for my coffee now. I can stress to the keto crowd.
That's right. You can keto your way into their heart.
Beautiful. So do you have any other shout outs you want to give before we wrap this thing? Thank you so, so much for being on with us today. This is so amazing to get to talk to you and hear a little bit about your inside process and everything that's going on. So Thank you for
having me. I guess just tune into Wing It Wednesdays coming back in February. The TGI episodes are on my YouTube and now on Rumble, the official Dina Carter channel. And my socials are Instagram is Dina Tunes, Twitter is Dina Sings, and Facebook is official Dina Carter as well. So just check me out there. I'm
official
always
official Dina
doing
Carter,
something.
Funky Coma Dina.
That's right.
Thank you so much for everything. We can't wait to catch up with you again soon. So keep in touch, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Dina.
Thanks. Bye.
I cannot believe we just got to hear from Dina Carter herself. And she's saying strawberry wine and you and tequila. If you guys only knew how much that really meant, I hope that I am giving that off to you, because she's such an inspiration and such an icon. And I absolutely love both of those songs so much. So for her to sit here and sing them for us, I was behind the screen like freaking out. I hope you guys are having as much fun as I am with this show, and keep following along because you keep seeing it. I mean, we've had some pretty amazing guests so far, and I think they're only going to keep coming, hopefully. And maybe Miss Dina Carter will have a friend she recommends us to, and maybe she'll come back on. She's going to have some new music coming out pretty soon. So maybe we'll have to do another little recap and catch up with her, because that was just so awesome. I'm going to do one more song for you tonight. This will be one of my songs. That's how I've been kind of doing this so far. I've been starting with something you might know, you can sing along to, and then wrap the show with one of mine. Because I am going to have my own record coming out. And it's kind of funny that you're getting a chance to see and hear some of these songs before it really does. You guys can give me some input on what I should include. Maybe, I don't know that I'm going to be able to fit all of them since we've written over 200 songs. So I really do take what you say seriously. I really take it into consideration if you have a favorite. All right, Valentine's Day is coming up. I'm going to do a love song. I hope you guys can put yourselves into this one and take it wherever you want to go with it. It's called This Story.
There's all kinds of sweetness and all kinds of crazy. And heaven, my God, there's so many days we go running around with our heads in the clouds. Driving a heart, it's a good place to start the story. In chapter one, it's always good fun. I'm telling my friends that this could be the one. He opens the door and leaves me with kisses. Before he goes, I'm already missing the story. Writing the words one day at a time. I can't believe that these stories are all mine. I wished for a star and I got the whole sky. Fact or fiction, this story's all mine. In chapter 2, is it all about you? Or all about us keeping the trust? Will we swear on a diamond? We'll always keep shining. And when we get older, we'll never grow cold in this story. Writing the words one day time. I can't believe that these stories are all mine. I wished for a star and I got the whole sky. Fact or fiction, this story's all mine. But I've read stories like this, and in the end, he doesn't exist. Oh, how can I turn this page in the wind? This story's everything.
Thank you so much for joining me tonight for Fired Up Live episode 9, you guys. Have a great night. I can't wait to see who wins that Firedust cooker. In today's world, time with family is more valuable than ever. Meet Firedust, the original portable propane cooker. It sets up in seconds, fires up fast, and cooks anything you throw at it. Whether it's a quick meal at home or in the great outdoors, Firedisk has you covered. Take your kitchen outside and enjoy everything that makes good food great. Firedisk, cooking at home made easy.